r belongs to w, such that the first coordinate is a, the second coordinate is 3 into first coordinate, and the third coordinate is 2 into first coordinate, right? So a 3a 2a. Okay, so again u plus v is equal to a1 plus a2, and the second coordinate is 3 into first coordinate, that is a1 plus a2, and the third coordinate is 2 into a1 plus a2, so that is also belongs to w. Again k into u is equal to k into u1 comma 3 into k a1 comma 2 into k a1. So you can easily try to understand that this set is also belongs to w. So both the condition are quite easily be proved. So w is a subspace of R3. The fourth one, w is equal to x, y, z, such that x square plus y square plus z square less or equal to 1. That means addition of all the square of all the coordinates should be less or equal to 1. Okay, so x square plus y square plus z square should be less or equal to 1. Only those type of element are in the set, right? And clearly this is a subset of R3, so we take V is equal to R3. Okay, take, you can see now here I want to prove that the given set is not a subspace. So it's quite easy. What I have to do, take any two elements from the set, any two particular elements from the set, and try to prove that that addition of that two particular elements is not in the set. Okay, so you can see that 1 0 0 belongs to W. Why 1 0 0 belongs to W? Because x square plus y square plus z square, that is 1 square plus 0 square plus 0 square is equal to 1, that is less or equal to 1, so it satisfied the condition. So u belongs to w. Now v is equal to 0 1 0. Okay, again 0 square plus 1 square plus 0 square is equal to 1, so again it satisfied the condition for the set, so that is also belongs to w. So u and v all both are belongs to w, right? And we take two particular elements from the set, 1 0 0 and 0 1 0. Now try to check the addition of that two element, u plus v. What is u plus v? U plus v is equal to 1 1 0. Okay, so clearly that is not belongs to w, because of 1 square plus 1 square plus 0 square, that is 1 plus 1 is 2. Okay, so that is 2 is not less or equal to 1. So not belongs to w. U plus v is not belongs to w. So w is not a subspace of R3. Okay, now next example is a subset of R2. You can see that subset of R2, w is equal to xy, where x square is equal to y square. So only those elements are in the set such that square of two coordinates are same. Okay, x square is equal to y square. Again here, again I want to prove that the given set is not a subspace of R2. So again I take two elements from the set, u is equal to minus 1 1. Clearly minus 1 square is 1 and 1 square is 1, so it satisfied the condition for the set. So u belongs to w, and v is equal to 1 1, that is also belongs to w. Okay, but you can see, what is u plus v? U plus v is 0 2. So clearly it not satisfied the condition for the set, that is because 0 square, that is not equal to 2 square. 0 square is 0, 2 square is 4, so 0 is not equal to 4, so it dropped the condition for the set. So clearly u plus v is not belongs to w. Okay, so what we have proved, u and v, in both the example you can see on the screen, in both the example we prove that if we take u and v, two particular elements from the set, but u plus v is not in the set, so clearly w is not a subspace of R2, that is not R3, actually it's R2. Okay, the next example, w is equal to xy. Again this is also a subset of R2, w is equal to xy, where x greater or equal to 0 and y greater or equal to 0. Okay, subset of R2. So take u is equal to 1, 1 belongs to w. Okay, and k into u, take k is equal to minus 1. Okay, here we use standard scalar multiplication. So minus 1 into u, that is minus 1 into 1, 1, that is equal to minus 1 minus 1. Clearly, that is not belongs to w. So here, maybe the addition, the first condition may be it satisfied, but second condition is not satisfied. So w is not a subspace of R2, okay, because the second condition is dropped for the particular element 1, 1. Now the next example w, that is subset of set of 2 cross 2 matrices A, B, C, D in matrix A, first coordinate is A, second is B, C, D, row wise, that is equal to A, B, C, D belongs to R, and the condition is addition of all the 4 coordinates should be 0. Addition of all the 4 coordinates must be 0. Now we prove that the given set is a subspace. If we take u is equal to a1, b1, c1, d1 belongs to w, so this element is belongs to w, so that's why it satisfied the condition, that is a1 plus b1 plus c1 plus d1 is equal to 0. Again, second matrix v is equal to a2, b2, c2, d2 belongs to w, so again a2 plus b2 plus c2 plus d2 is equal to 0. Okay, so u plus v, now we want to check u plus v. What is u plus v? U plus v is equal to a1 plus a2, b1 plus b2, c1 plus c2 and d1 plus d2. This is belongs to w. This u plus v belongs to w. Why? Because you can see addition of all the 4 coordinates, that is in bracket a1 plus a2 plus in bracket b1 plus b2 plus in bracket c1 plus c2 plus in bracket d1 plus d2 is equal to 0. Because of we have that a1 plus b1 plus c1 plus d1 is 0 and a2 plus b2 plus c2 plus d2 is 0. Okay, so that's why this term becomes 0. So u plus v belongs to w, and k into u, that is equal to k into a1, k into b1, k into c1 and k into d1, that is also belongs to w because of addition of all the 4 coordinates, k a1 plus k b1 plus k c1 plus k d1 is equal to 0. The next example, it's quite interesting. This example, w is equal to set of n cross n matrices. So all the square matrices are in the set, all the square matrices, okay, set of n cross n matrices, but only those type of square matrices are in the set such that if a into x is equal to 0, then x is equal to 0. Okay, so this capital X is actually a x1, x2 up to xn. This capital X is actually a column vector, that is x1, x2 up to xn. Okay, so only those type of square matrices. Try to understand first of all the set, what type of element, what type of matrices are in the set. Only those type of square matrices are in the set such that a into x is equal to 0, then x is equal to 0. Okay, and this is, but obvious, this is a subset of set of all n cross n matrices. So v is equal to set of n cross n matrices. Now check the given set is subspace or not. So my answer is this set is not a subspace. Try to check, take a is equal to 1 1 0 1 belongs to w. Now why this is belongs to w? Because here is the reason that 1 1 0 1 into x1 x2 is equal to 0 0, then this two equation happen that x1 plus x2 is equal to 0 and x2 is equal to 0. So you can see that x1 and x2 both are 0, so capital X is 0, so it satisfied the condition for the set. So that's why a is equal to 1 1 0 1 belongs to W. Also B, B is equal to minus 1, 1, 0, minus 1 belongs to W. Since minus 1, 1, 0, minus 1 into x1, x2, that is equal to 0, 0. So minus x1 plus x2 is equal to 0 and minus x2 is also 0. So x1 is equal to 0 and x2 is equal to 0. But a plus b, what is a plus b? 0 to 0, 0, because a is equal to 1, 1, 0, 1 and b is equal to minus 1, 1, 0, minus 1. So a plus b is equal to 0 to 0, 0, that is not belongs to W. Because of 0 to 0, 0 into x1, x2 is equal to 0, 0, then we only get one equation, that is 2x2 is equal to 0. So only we get x2 is equal to 0, but x1 not equal to 0. Okay, so capital X is not equal to 0. So that's why the given set is not a subspace of set of n cross n matrices. Okay, so that is quite good example, interesting example. And all the example are very important. Some examples are asked in the GTU question papers. Next topic is linear combination. This is the definition. Now a vector W is called a linear combination of a vector v1, v2 up to vr if it can be expressed as a linear combination of v1, v2 up to vr. That means it can be expressed in the form W is equal to k1 v1 plus k2 v2 up to kr vr, where k1, k2, k3 up to kr are scalars. Okay, so here is the first example. Try to check that express a vector v is equal to 7, 4, minus 3 as a linear combination of v1 and v2. V1 is equal to 1, minus 2, minus 5 and v2 is equal to 2, 5, 6. So we check that the given set v, given element v, given vector v as a linear combination of v1 and v2. Okay, so we need to prove that scalars k1 and k2 such that v can be expressed as v is equal to k1 v1 plus k2 v2. If we can find such scalars k1, k2, then we can say that v can be expressed as linear combination of v1 and v2. And if we cannot find such scalars k1 and k2, then v cannot be expressed as a linear combination of v1 and v2. So let's try to see that. Suppose v can be expressed as linear combination of v1 and v2. So that can be written as, instead of k1 and k2, here I use a and b. Okay, just interchange the coefficients. Instead of k1 and k2, which you can see in the definition, k1, k2 up to kr, but instead of k1, k2 up to kr, here I use simple a and b. Okay, so a into v1 plus b into v2 is equal to v. Suppose v can be expressed as linear combination of v1 and v2, so we can express a into v1 plus b into v2, that is equal to v. So from the first step we will get the two equations, that is a plus 2b is equal to 7 and 2a minus 2a plus 5b is equal to 4 and minus 5a plus 6b is equal to minus 3. And now our target is to find a and b. Okay, our target is to find a and b. So these three equations we can use using the matrix. Okay, so the matrix become 1 2 7. You can see the first, what is the first equation? A plus 2b is equal to 7. So first row of the matrix is a 2 7. Okay, second equation is minus 2a plus 5b is equal to 4. So the second row is minus 2, 5, 4. Okay, the first column is the coefficient of the a, the second column is the coefficient of b, and the third column is the right side coefficient. So minus 2, 5, 4. And the third row is minus 5, 6, minus 3, that is from the third equation, minus 5a plus 6b is equal to minus 3. Now, first of all, we try to convert this matrix into row echelon form. Otherwise, we cannot solve this equation. So, we have to try, we have to convert this matrix into row echelon form. Okay. I hope that you all know that what is row echelon form, right? That is, so one, again I repeat, what is row echelon form? That is, in first row, whatever the leading entry, below the leading entry, all the elements should be 0. Again, in second row, whatever the leading entry, means first non-zero row of the first non-zero element of the row. Okay. So, below the leading entry, it should be 0. Leading entry should be left to right whenever we go from above to below. Okay. That is the second condition to become a row echelon form. So, I hope that you all know what is row echelon form. So, we convert this matrix into row echelon form. We multiply first row with 2 and add into second row, and we multiply first row with 5 and add into third row. Okay. So, this next matrix is 1, 2, 7, 0, 9, 18 and 0, 16, 32. Okay. That you can easily check with the some numerical methods. Okay. Again, try to in second row, the leading entry is 9. So, we need to try that one is 1. So, we divide it second row with 1 upon 9. So, here is the third process, second process. We divide it second row with 1 by 9 and third row with 1 by 16. So, you can see 1, 2, 7, 0, 1, 2 and 0, 1, 2. So, second and third row are same. And the next process is when we multiply second row with minus 1 and add into third row, because of second and third row are same, the third row become 0, 0, 0. Okay. So, a plus 2b is equal to 7. Final equation is a plus 2b is equal to 7 and b is equal to 2. So, a is equal to 3 and b is equal to 2, that we will get. So, put this two value, put value of a and b in the first equation, 3 into 1 minus 2 minus 5 plus 2 into 2 5 6 is equal to 7 4 minus 3. So, 3 into 1 minus 2 minus 5 plus 2 into 2 5 6 is equal to 7 4 minus 3.